Hello everyone, I am Dr. Yogesh Pawde. I am associated with Department of Biochemistry inside GS Medical College and KM Hospital, Mumbai. I welcome you to the session in this lecture series on clinical enzymology. Before going through this session before you watch this video, I will recommend you go to the playlist on clinical enzymology and watch the first video in which we have covered general enzymology and the properties of isoenzymes, and then come back and watch this video and understand the enzymatic cardiac markers which are going to be covered in this session. We'll compare these enzymatic cardiac markers now, which will give you a good idea about their rise, peak and fall, or the duration for which they are increased. Okay, so we have discussed enzymatic markers in this session, okay, but I have covered non-enzymatic markers for comparison here so that we get a good idea about the utility of enzymatic as well as non-enzymatic markers. CKMB, if you see, it starts rising early, 3 to 6 hours, and LDH starts very late, 12 to 24 hours, but it remains elevated for 8 to 14 days. So, if the patient is reporting to you after a subclinical myocardial infarction, so it might have just manifested in the form of chest pain and it recovered. And ECG will show you old infarct, but that will not show you how old it was. Okay. So, if after a week of subclinical myocardial infarction, the patient reports to you and you find an old infarct, so how will you investigate or keep, right? So how old the infarct was? So you can do LDH1 to LDH2 ratio and find out whether the LDH1 is still elevated or not. If the patient luckily reports to you within 14 days, and if you find LDH1 to LDH2 ratio is increased, you can say that it was recent old infarct which may need treatment or management for preventive action, so that the further episodes of myocardial infarction can be prevented. Here, the gamma GGT, it is very late to rise and it remains elevated for 4 weeks. So, the gamma GGT is only related to the repair process. Whenever there is a trouble, when there is a blockage and because of which there is myocardial infarction, so if the myocardium starts developing collateral for the recirculation, right? So the angioblastic activity in that area will show you increase in gamma GGT activity, and that is just related to the repair process after the myocardial infarction and not because of myocardial infarction it is rising. Okay, so for any angioblastic activity or any repair process wherein there is development of blood vessels, it will show you increase in GGT levels. Okay, and that the same happens in a repair process of myocardial infarction as well. Coming to the non-enzymatic markers here, cardiac troponin I and T, okay, they start rising within 4 hours. So, almost similar to CKMB, okay. But cardiac troponin T remains elevated for 10 days, maximum 10 days. And if you see myoglobin, it starts rising immediately after the myocardial infarction. Okay, so 1 to 4 hours. So, if there is an MCQ, which is the earliest cardiac marker? If the stem of the MCQ do not state whether it is enzymatic or non-enzymatic, and you find an option of myoglobin and CKMB both, you have to choose myoglobin, because the stem do not specify whether it is enzymatic or non-enzymatic. Choose myoglobin in that case. If the stem says which is the earliest enzymatic marker, okay, and the options, 4 options contain both CKMB and myoglobin, choose a CKMB, because the stem says it is which is the enzymatic marker, right? So earliest enzymatic is CKMB, earliest non-enzymatic is myoglobin, and the earliest cardiac marker when nothing is specified, it remains the myoglobin. This is a chart where you can get a fair idea of rise, peak and fall of respective enzymatic cardiac marker, CKMB, total CK, then here myoglobin is also there, LDH, late to rise and late to fall. So here you can get a good idea of comparison of cardiac markers. So thank you very much. Guys, if you find this content useful for your studies and it gives you a good idea of enzymatic cardiac markers, so I'll request you to like and share the video, and at the same time I'll request you to subscribe to the channel to get notified about the upcoming videos, and please press the bell button so that you get the notifications in real time. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching, and please keep motivating us. Thank you so much.